The following presentation is rated N for
non-garbage. Stallion Hunter.
I welcome you all to this meeting of the Stallion Hunters. As you know, I'm your producer, Jim Bob.
I propose
we work with the scientific method to draw conclusions and research a certain species of animal. Does anybody have any suggestions?
Well, we could do the Chevalier horse. I've been doing some research on it, and it really only eats grass. So we could ask, could it survive without eating grass?
Of course, I agree with you. Boy, do you ever do that?
I think it could survive without eating grass.
Very nice. Norm, do you have anything to add to this whole deal?
Well, honestly, if grass is removed from the Chevalier horse's diet, then I think the Chevalier horse will be able to survive by other means of supplements, like oats or hay, because clearly grass is not the only viable food source.
I propose we have a controlled experiment. We have one horse receiving feed and another horse receiving grass. Our independent variable shall be what the horse is fed. Dependent shall be the result that we get because of the feed. We shall have control variables such as our climate, our temperature, and the horse's initial health. What do you guys think?
I think I did it.
Come on, go.
Welcome to this week's edition of the Stallion Hunter.
Stallion Hunter!
My name's Norm, and this week we've traveled to Central Mongolia to visit the Shabalski's horse, or otherwise known as a wild Mongolian horse or the top. Joining me today is Darby, a native of Mongolia, whose ancestors have built a very nice shack for us that have housed many a Shabalski's horse.
With him today is his trusted translating assistant, Diesel.
He will be assisting us throughout the day. Darby, please tell us more about the Shabalski's horse.
Thank you for joining us, Norm. We have previously captured some of the Chevalier's horse, and we need help performing an experiment on him. And by the way, for the general public, we are not trying to resurrect communism outside of China. Thank you.
Anyway, we will soon be conducting an experiment on the feeding habits of the Chevalier's horse. Please come with me as we do this. As you see here, a caretaker of Malibu, one of the Chevalier's horse, is combing his precious hair.
Please, Darby.
Tell us more about Malibu's habitat, what she eats.
A brief structure function description of how certain body parts of her work in eating, and then a brief trophic description of how she fills into the food chain.
Well, Mr. Norm, I believe I'll put it to you like this. Malibu is a Chevalier's horse, and living on the wild plains of Mongolia as a wild trotter for so many centuries and millennia at a time, it has evolved in so many ways, and so that its structure dry arid plains, it has strong, sturdy legs to gallop and remain free as many times as it needs, never falling or being domesticated. Look at these teeth. Look at the teeth. The teeth. It has teeth. And these teeth are excellent for eating grass, which is composed of a main part. Thank you, dear caretaker. It's composed of a main part of the diet. Look at those things. Look at those shiny, pearly points. Look at them. Look at this! But these are perfect for eating. And it has a strong, sturdy back. Very useful. It allows it to trot, run, and it allows it to remain free and gallop across the plains of Mongolia, away from all predators. Speaking of which, the Mongolian trotter lacks any predators in the wild. It is high in the food chain, in this sense, in that it eats grass, which comes from. Is they have no predators except for the Nazgul, as seen in J.R. Tolkien's Third Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King. Dobby.
I did not know you spoke very good English.
Where did you learn this from, Kippy?
I
used Rosetta Stone English. Only cost you $49.99. Go to rosettastone.com and order today.
Yes.
Now, if you'll follow me over here to my other specimen.
Midnight. Classic example of a Chevalier's horse stallion. Kingdom Animalia. Phylum Chordata.
Family Equidae.
Species Chevalier. This is where the Chevalier's horse stands in the great scheme of hierarchy.
As you can see here, Malibu is quite enjoying her feast on some delicious green fresh grass. As you can see again, she loves it.
She does indeed.
Our previous control group, this experimental group, Lloyd and I, shall feed Midnight this breakfast.
Yep. There you have it.
And now, the placebo group.
Alright, here we are, watching Shadowfax feed on some grass. Another Chevalier's horse specimen. Oh wait! That's not grass, it's AstroTurf! No!
And now, a short message from our sponsors.
Hello. Hello, I'm Attorney Pranav Basala. Have you or your loved ones ever been physically abused by a coach claiming to teach PE? If so, you may be entitled to receive a large cash award. If you or your loved ones have symptoms such as torn or damaged muscles, emotional distress, an extreme hatred of PE coaches, or even death, call the number on the screen immediately.
Hey Dean.
Hey Batwell.
Let's make it from 50s. Alright, line it up.
Look at Garfunkel. No, look at the cook kid. Love my job. Alright, here they go again.
I'm tired, coach. I need some water.
Tough it out, Uncle. Yeah.
Remember, we don't get paid unless you do.
And now, back to our scheduled program!
On this experiment, we have learned that Midnight accepted the feed, Malibu accepted the grass, and just in the nick of time, we saved Shadowfax from ingesting the poisonous astroturf.
Indeed, we have found that grass is not the only food source for the Schwalski's horse. Also, grain and oats are feasible food sources for the Schwalski. Let's prove it our hypothesis.
The heart is a blue, shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck.
I propose that we work with the scientific methods and draw conclusions on open feet, which means that we'll only receive grass. For an independent variable, our horse is fed food. This feeds grass. That will be our control group. Our independent variable is what the horse is fed. Dependent is the horse's health after the fed.
Oh my god. They keep messing it up.
Cut that. We are not trying to destroy the world.
Bernabe Dobby,
Wobby Wobby, Bernabe Dobby, Wobby Wobby, Bernabe Dobby, Wobby Wobby.